Whenever you're performing an experiment, you're dealing with errors. And broadly, you can categorize them into systematic errors and random errors. In this video, we're going to look at the difference between those two, what impact they have on your experiments, and then we're also going to look a little bit at error management. But then again, the video is also setting the stage for my next video about replication, randomization, and blocking in the context of design of experiments, or DOE. Let's take a look at the difference between random errors and systematic errors first. First of all, the random errors, they arise from unpredictable or uncontrollable variations that you have in your experimental process. And these random errors can occur due to fluctuations in your measurement instruments that you use, variations that you have there, but also environmental changes like slight changes in the temperature or humidity that you experience while performing the experiments. Then, in contrary, we have the systematic errors, which are consistent and repeatable errors that occur due to flaws in your experimental setup or procedure. The systematic errors, they are also more problematic than the random errors because they bias your experimental results and they are often harder to detect and correct. And common sources for systematic errors are often instrument calibration issues, like if the calibration of your instrument is not correct, all the measurements that you take, they will be consistently off. Or another example could be biased sampling. If you consider that you take a sample from a mixture and you have not properly mixed that mixture and you only take that sample from the very top, then that is also a bias in your result and it will also cause your result being consistently off if you do that all the time. But how do these random errors and systematic errors affect your results, your measurements? First of all, we need to distinguish between accuracy and precision. Now, accuracy refers to how close the experimental results are to the true value, and precision denotes how reproducible your results are. So that means that typically random errors, they affect the precision of your experiment, and the systematic errors, they affect the accuracy. Or in other words, random errors make your experiments or your results more variable, and systematic errors, they cause a consistent deviation from the true value. Since we cannot prevent these types of errors completely, we need to have a proper error management. Now, there is that one key principle when it comes to error management, and it's block what you can and randomize what you can't. And this principle emphasizes on the importance of controlling for known sources of variability, blocking, and using randomization to mitigate the impact of unknown and uncontrollable factors. And these two principles are part of the three key principles in DOE, which is blocking, randomization, and replication. And we take a look at those key principles in my next video.